Hello, my name is Austin, and today I want to provide an update regarding the Echo Smartpens. The Echo Smartpens are made by the company LiveScribe, and basically the LiveScribe currently only offers the Symphony Smartpen. The Symphony Smartpen is an improvement on the Azure Smartpen, where the pen cap now acts as the power for on and off. So you take it off, it automatically turns on. That's really the only difference between that and the Azure. The Symphony's currently out of stock except for the special edition model last time I looked at their website. And what's fascinating is that there will be an Echo 2 Smart Pen to replace the Echo Smart Pen. Now, the Echo Smart Pen is unique to the Symphony or Azure Smart Pens because it has a built-in microphone. This makes it ideal for educational institutions, because in class the student is able to record directly with their microphone in the Smart Pen. They do not need a computer to connect to, or a tablet or smartphone for connecting. It's all done right from the Smart Pen because of the built-in microphone. I am hopeful, from what I hear, that the Echo 2 may be released in September. There is, from what the rumors I've heard about, they're saying that the Echo 2 Smart Pen will actually have the same design. It will have a similar design because it will use the same ink and it will use the same paper as the Echo Smart Pen, is what I've been hearing. So we'll see if that's true. Also, because of the chip shortage, you know, the Echo Smart Pen could be pushed back, you know, maybe until 2022. We'll see, you know, what LiveScribe is able to do. It does seem like they're having a lot of supply constraints and issues making, you know, their pens and keeping everything in stock. The other thing that I think is fascinating is what to do right now for students who have a Smart Pen accommodation, and let's say you don't have a Smart Pen available. What would be the way to kind of go about solving this for a short-term accommodation? To me personally, I would lean toward the Otter AI technology, which is it records and then it also transcribes with around 90% accuracy rate. And I find that to be the closest thing as far as providing some type of support for a student who is used to using a Smart Pen. They could use that for a semester or whatnot until the new Smart Pens are provided in stock. And one of the reasons I would say that is very, very valuable, or close to providing the same service as a Smart Pen, or, you know, close as possible, is that it doesn't really require use of a computer. For example, Microsoft OneNote does the same recording and it will sync it right with whatever line you type. You can actually hear the recording off it. I will do a future video on Microsoft OneNote and showing that feature. But the point that I'm looking to make here is that basically most students who are choosing the Smart Pen are choosing it because they want to handwrite. And so if you look at a lot of the different options available, most of them, like Gleam or the Microsoft OneNote, those are computer-based options that I don't think would be as favorable. The other option, other than using Otter AI and having the student handwrite and then go back to use Otter if they miss something or want to look at the transcript, would be to consider something like Notability. Notability does have the same type of recording feature as the Smart Pen, as the Echo Smart Pen or the Symphony Smart Pen if you're using it with a smartphone or tablet. But the thing is that Notability only works with a tablet, and you really need a stylus in order to use it, and not every student has that, and it would probably be pretty expensive for educational institutions to provide those to all the students waiting on Smart Pens. So that's why I think Otter AI right now is probably the best option. But overall, I just kind of wanted to give you a little update about Smart Pens and what's going on. I hope you found it informative, and thank you so much for watching.